Namaste YouTube, welcome to Cafe Enoma and welcome to our marathon of Rush and Black Sabbath. Today, right now, we are going to give our reaction to four songs of Rush, and starting with Subdivisions. It will be followed by Freewill, Fly By Night and Bastille Day.
All in the same video so that you can enjoy them in one go. And, you know, I mean, hopefully enjoy them in one go as well as ponder, contemplate, reflect on them later.
Yes.
Let's get started with Subdivisions. It's going to be a single take, first time, honest, pure reaction by Kirti and me. Although Subdivisions, we did watch a reaction 3 or 4 months ago on Weibo Reacts. We had watched his reaction, so we do know a bit about Subdivision, the music, but we didn't really get into the lyrics and neither did he. So let's get started with Subdivisions by Rush.
We'll be right back.
This seems to be an album or song from the synth era of Rush. You had Gedili predominantly playing the synthesizer throughout the song. Great, great keyboard playing. You had Alex Lifeson on the lead guitar. You had Neil Peart on the drums. Gedili, of course, singing it too. And very beautifully. A bit later, actually. Either way, beautiful lyrics. It's very pertinent, something that connects with everybody. Length and breadth of the world. This is a problem, whether you talk about the corporate offices. I love the lines, which the chorus, which talks about basement bars, school halls and things. Mm-hmm. So there, you whether you go to a mall, whether you go to a corporate, enter the corporate world, whether you talk about banks, whether you talk about any institutions, whether schools, offices, hospitals, anywhere basically you go, you have to confirm or you're left out. It's no different now than it was back then when this probably was released. So Subdivisions is all about that particular person who was outcast, you know, the loner. Possibly he became a loner because of that, being outcast, because he did not confirm, you know, to whatever is he is supposed to conform to, the guidelines of that particular institution, the guidelines of that particular system, the guidelines of that particular place. And you can see that more evidently online these days and on social media. It's very, very evident, very, very strong that either you love this band or you don't love this band. Either you love this celebrity or you don't love this celebrity. Either you watch this movie, love this movie, love the stars of this movie, or get out of here. So basically, it's quite evident on social media these days. In fact, that's how, what has actually probably given birth to trolls. That's how it all started. That there's some who confirm and some who don't. And evidently, those who don't, today's world have actually outnumbered on many platforms the ones that do confirm. So it's an interesting platform now. Whether you talk about YouTube, whether you talk about Twitter, whether you talk about Facebook, whether you talk about Instagram, whether you talk about WhatsApp groups, even though they're just 250 in number, 50 at most times is the average, you know, group size of WhatsApp, most groups. Even there, you either confirm and agree to whatever is being said and done or get lost. What are your thoughts, Kirti? All yours.
Wow. It's been a while we have given a listen to Rush, and this was refreshing. I love the drums. I really like the drums. I could hear the, you know, set that he was playing.
The drum,
almost towards the end also when he did that. Wow, that was prominent. On the instrumental front, that was very prominent what was done on the drums. Coming to the lyrics, subdivisions. We do have a lot of sub-categories, subdivisions, sub-sections, sub-dissections, or whatever you call in the society. And they're pretty tight packs. We can call them packs. Packs here, packs there, borders here, borders there, everywhere. Everything. And either you be part of it or you be the outcast. You'll be cool if you're agreeing to everything, even when it costs your own identity to be abolished. But at that cost also, there are a lot of people who enter, who want to enter that pack so that they can be part of something and they can have the satisfaction of being with certain people. And I guess that's what the song is about. It's about having your individual identity or not having one and being more popular.
I like the title of the song, Subdivisions. It's a very interesting mechanical kind of title, giving it a physical form.
That's what it started with, geometrical forms.
Yeah,
like,
so I like that. I like that research done by Neil Peart, probably, if he's written it. I like that aspect, and I must mention the great lead guitar playing by Alex Lifeson towards the end. I love that part. So we'll move on to the next song very quickly, and perhaps we'll have a longer chat if we have time towards the end, but now we'll take it to the next song. It's Freewill, next on our list.
Okay.
Freewill, first time single take, honest reaction. Let's get started with this one, shall we?
Yeah.
And we'd be most interested in learning any trivia about any of these songs. There are many, many subscribers who come to most of our reactions now for the first time. And we know it for a fact because our patrons itself are in a large number watching all reactions. So any trivia you can share about the particular songs that would help them get into Rush, listen to Rush, more purposefully, it would be great. And for us too, we would love to know about these particular four songs that you guys have selected.
We'll be right back.
outstanding. The music in this one was
yes.
upper crust stuff. I love the both the guitars. I love the synthesizer. I love the drumming, of course. So crisp, so clean. Wow, this was upper crust stuff for the music by itself. The pertinent message is quite clear. I'll let you have a go and then I'll button a bit later. You could also, when I'm talking, you could also play the first verse because I kind of missed that.
Me too.
Yeah, but we'll do that later. First, your say.
Okay. First of all, there was ferocious drumming and guitaring. I don't know if it was Alex Lifeson who was playing the lead guitar heavily or what was going on, because these days, I don't know, I'm getting a bit confused between the lead guitar when it is played differently. And the bass guitar, really don't know what is happening with me, but that is happening for sure. So I'm assuming this was all the way the lead guitar and played a bit heavy.
Yeah.
That's what I'm assuming. Forgive me if that is a mistake. But loved it the way it was going, you know, when the solo was going on, it was going traveling from one ear to the other. This was different. We have heard a lot of songs of Rush, but musically this was very powerful, heavy duty musical song.
Yeah, it's powerful, it's memorable.
And the bit where Gerilly became quite shrill towards the end, almost the last verse, that reminded me of King Diamond. You know, changing the voice and making it so shrill, it reminded me of King Diamond when he gets into the paranormal entity or the ghosts of the devil's characters. So that was... suddenly it came. It was quite surprising. What I gathered from the song was many of us blindly follow the scriptures, the books that are written. That's what was the first line in the chorus. That celestial guide we follow, what everybody else has preached and told us and written in the books, whether you follow your holy books or other guides. And some people, you know, want something or the other in life, but what I want is the free will. Even when you don't want to make a decision, you have already made a choice. Even not making a decision, not stepping forward also is a choice. I like that line. But what I value the most, what I cherish the most is the free will to do things that I want when I want.
Yeah, free will is pretty important in the movies as well. Immediately, Bruce Almighty comes to mind.
Yes.
So, you know, it has a very, very important role to play in the movie, free will. That you can't really mess with free will. You can do anything almost, even if you're God, but you can't even mess with free will. And yes, definitely we are part of society, we are part of a system. And whether we like it or not, yes, sometimes we do have to conform to particular practices, faiths, religions. We are born into a particular religion in a family. We are born into a particular system in a particular society. And yes, there are rebels all the time. There are people who take the other way out. There are people walk in the other direction. And this is an example of it that Rush is talking about. That at the end of the day, they want their conscience to be clear and they want to take up something that is totally their choice. It's something which is not imposed upon them by their parents, by society, by the institutions. It's something that they want to take up on their own free will. And that's perfectly all right with me and with anyone else, I guess. It's your own free will. It's your own freedom. It's your own choice. What you follow, what you don't follow. And definitely that's well written.
This is the first verse that you heard.
There are those who think that life is nothing left to chance. Host of holy horrors to direct the English dance. Okay, that's fine. So that's enough. So basically, this is what the song is about for me. What will remember? Definitely, the title of the song is perfect, based on what the lyrics were all about. So this is something good about this particular song of Rush. Apart from that, as we already mentioned, the music is fantastic in this one. It's memorable. It's got a catchy tune. It's got a positive vibe. It's taking up a topic again that's pertinent, just like the last one. It seems to be of the same era, you know, the same era, the same style of music. So I'm assuming that it's one after the other, or one year after the other, one after the next album. this music vibe is pretty similar to Subdivisions. And it's also similar to other songs we have reacted to in the past, of course. A host of them, more than 5 dozen of them. But it's similar to Limelight comes to mind immediately, Tom Sawyer. So because of the excessive use of the lead guitar and synthesizer player and the common runs of the drums, you know, this drums have a common thread. It's done differently, but it has a common thread that, you know, it's Neil Peart on the drums, his drum rolls, the way he plays them, which drums he selects. It has a peculiar sound, which is very crisp, very sharp, and you know it's Rush. You know it's him on the drums, and you know it's Rush you're listening to. Great song. I think it's about time we move to the next. Perhaps after the next, we'll have to take a break because it's 23 minutes on the clock. Okay. So let's get started with the next one, Fly By Night.
Fly By Night.
Fly yes. By Night. What do you think it's about? Since we have a bit more time, since we are going to stop before the
fly by one. Night is a phrase where it's referred to the people who appear and disappear, especially scams, you know. And
yeah, fly by night operators is pretty common to me. I thought it would be something else, or you would say it something else. So fly by night operators are basically quite, it was common at one point of time, who in overnight literally they fleece their customers. And they're off. You don't even know where they are. Yeah. It happens with restaurants at times. It happens with shops.
Lottery.
And if you're unlucky, it may happen at bigger institutions like the banks and elsewhere. You know, where you invest a lot of money and scheme, some Ponzi scheme or some other such scheme. And you invest a lot of money. They win over your trust with dim lights, good buffet food, and a stellar presentation. So, let's hope this one's about that. Or we are... Either way, I hope you enjoyed. Fly By Night, the third song on our list. We'll take a small break after this one, but it will be in the same video that we react to the fourth song, which is Bastille Day. And may I remind you all our first time Super Day on the sea actions.
Time.
nicely done at the end, singing. This one is pretty simple, straightforward, Kirti. What are your thoughts on the music and the lyrics?
Music was good and I like the song, Fly By Night, and just want to get away from here. But only confusion is he's saying goodbye, my dear. He wants to change his life, start it again. But his ship isn't coming and he can't pretend. The ship isn't coming, where is he going?
No, he's leaving because the ship isn't coming. He was waiting for something good to happen.
Okay.
He was waiting for things to work out.
Okay.
Whatever he was doing, whether it was business, his career, his purpose, whatever he was chasing, the goals, he was waiting for it to come. And when you say ship hasn't come in, it means that you were waiting for things to work out.
Waiting for it is,
but it's not working out.
It isn't happening.
And it's interesting to note that he's leaving his girlfriend or wife.
Or somebody who
matters. His darling behind. Yeah.
So, luckily, I give my reactions with you. Otherwise, I was really confused. He's saying, fly by night, I want to go away and change my life and start over again. And then at the end, he says, my ship isn't coming and I can't pretend. So, I said, when his ship isn't coming, where is he going? How is he going to go? So, luckily, you said that. Yeah. This is crystal clear what the lyrics are saying, that he wants to change and start his life one more time, all over again. Because what is going on isn't working out. But he wants to give it another shot, start everything all over again.
Yeah, that's basically the crux of what I understood from this particular song.
Very powerful vocals by Kirti.
Powerful vocals. I like the emphasis on the end and the last line right at the end of the song. Great guitar solo once again by Alex Lifeson. It's good. It's pretty good. It's pretty refreshing to listen to them after so long. And the song is pretty clear. It's start afresh. You know, things aren't working out. You've tried a lot. You've waited. You've been patient. And I guess that's what's the need of the hour. Why he's leaving his girlfriend behind, that's a different question. But starting afresh is definitely the main core of the song. That if things aren't working out, your ship isn't coming in, go out, swim and reach another ship. Get there. It doesn't matter how you get there, as long as you get there. So that's what he's doing. He's definitely, I mean, take Sir Thomas Edison, for example. He tried 9,999 times towards inventing the electric light bulb. He didn't give up. So he just started afresh. Each time he failed, he started afresh. He looked at his failure as a try, as a trial, if you want to call it that, as an experiment, if you want to call it that. Another experiment in the number of experiments towards inventing the electric light bulb. We talk about, you know, the guy who ran the Roger Bannister, I guess you've not heard about him. The first guy ever to run the mile under 4 minutes. You know, for practically 40 years, if I'm not mistaken, since the Olympics started. Yeah, the 36 to 40 years of the Olympics, I mean, every 4 years it happens. So after so many Olympics, 7 or 8 Olympics, people were trying all over the world to run the mile. You know, there was a race, which was the mile race. So people were trying to run it in under 4 minutes, but no one could do it. Then along came Roger Bannister. His belief system was that he could do it. He had failed. Prior to that race, he had failed many, many times. But he went there with the belief that he could do it. Whatever failures he had, he used it as a stepping stone towards reaching that mile barrier, breaking that mile barrier in under 4 minutes. And that's what he did. And you know what happened? After he did it, there were thousands of people who did it. It's like the 100 monkey effect that we talked about in a couple of reactions in the past and our classes too. You know, once he did it, everyone saw that one person can do it, so can I, so can we. So everyone did it after that, practically everyone. Today you talk about a mile in under 4 minutes, most of the runners who qualify, of course, for the Olympics or major sporting events, they do it in under 4 minutes. So it's all about that one person. So same here. He's realized this isn't working out. I've tried this. What he's tried, we don't know. So it's ambiguous. We don't know what he's been trying. But whatever it is, he's given up. He realized that this is not working out. And I need to start afresh. My ship isn't coming in. There's no payday around the corner. Let's head out to the ocean. Let's take a different route. Let's get it done a different way.
Nice.
Let's start afresh. And thanks to people like that, the world is where it is today. You know, all inventions, major inventions and things of that have happened because of someone who started afresh. You know, major inventions. You talk about electric light bulb, you talk about the Velcro. You talk, some happened by mistake.
Everything.
You talk about potato chips. It happened by mistake.
By mistake. Yeah, somebody was fed up of the mundane routine of theirs and they wanted to change and they did something that got
The story behind the potato chips is that the guy who, he had this regular customer who would keep complaining at his restaurant, the chef. You know, he would keep calling out the chef and he would keep telling him that the potatoes are not made well, not done well, the fries or whatever he liked, you know. So this guy got, the chef was really pissed off. So one day he thought he'll teach him a lesson. And he basically, you know, literally overcooked the things, the potatoes. He overcooked them, he sliced them very thin first of all and he overcooked them. So much so that they became very crispy. And they were on the verge of being overcooked. So he served that and he thought, I've taught this guy a lesson.
They were dry and crispy.
But then this guy loved it and potato chips were born. So anyway, this is it for this particular one. Do you have anything to add at the end for this one?
This was great. All three songs that we given our reaction to so far have been great. It's, you know, feeling of satisfaction when
you give. You know what I'll do? I'll give you an opportunity to communicate more with the Rush fans who love you so much, who love connecting with you a lot more than they do with me, obviously. I'll allow you, I mean, not allow, it's your choice, but I'll give you that time in the next video. Because we need to stop the camera.
Yeah, we might be out of time.
Yeah. So
we are coming back with Bastille Day.
The last request is for Emerald and a few other Rush subscribers who have been with us from a long time, from January.
Yes.
First this year, probably, or second. Mm-hmm. So this one's for them, the last part of our reaction marathon of Rush.
Namaste, YouTube.
Yeah, we are continuing, so why is the namaste? Anyway, welcome back. Let's get started with our fourth reaction in our Rush reaction marathon. This one is for you guys, for the guys who stuck around from the beginning of Jan till now on our channel. I know that more than 200 guys are probably left out of the 800 subscribers that we have of Rush, you know, who predominantly arrived for Rush and stayed and have been part of our journey. Bastille Day.
Bastille Day. Bastille
Day. I guess you have something to say about it.
French National Day. And it's not that far away. It's going to come on 14th of July. So I guess only a couple of weeks, 2 weeks or so is left for Bastille Day. And what better timing could have been for this reaction than now?
Okay. Well, Bastille Day, if I'm not mistaken, is after the French Revolution, right?
Yeah, after the French Revolution when people united. And I don't know much of the French history, but I only know the Bastille Day celebrated on the 14th of July.
I think it's after the Revolution.
It dates back to 1719.
And the king and the queen and most of the main ministers or accomplices of his, most of the main people, they all were put under the guillotine. That much I remember, and that was Bastille Day.
Oh.
I guess that day was called Bastille Day. So it was like a huge victory after
the
prolonged uprising and revolt. The revolution that occurred, and that's what's called Bastille Day, I'm assuming. But of course, Rush often does it a bit differently at times. So we'll know what this one means.
The subject of the song.
Yeah, even though it's a historical event, let's listen to it and then have a discussion after that.
And let his kingdom rise.
Nice.
Wow.
This was enjoyable. All four songs.
Was,
and this most of all for the music.
You know, crafted, arranged in a way, it had aggression through the voice of Kirti and through the music it had glory and victory at the end.
Yeah, it kind of...
It gives you the feeling.
It gives you the vibe, it gives you the sense of satisfaction, the sense of victory. It's a great feeling towards the end. It's like the culmination of a long standing protest, a very, very long fight for independence, for freedom, and fighting against the oppression, rebelling against the kings, king and queen of that era. Very, very strong lyrics, very pertinent, very definitely connected to Bastille Day itself. I thought maybe it would be something else, but it wasn't that. So well done by Rash once again to stick to the topic and keep it significant, keep it accurate. I love the guitaring in this. The guitar work, the drumming was top notch. This was top notch. It was very enjoyable. It was clean. Those breaks were clean. It was a clean break and then it continued again. And that's always remarkable. It stands out. You kind of remember it instantly whenever it happens in a song and whenever it's done so precisely. And, you know, this was passion. This was, I guess, the passionate era of Rush. It could be sensed that they were all into it completely. They were fully focused. They were doing their thing the way they always wanted to do it. And this, I'm guessing this was Rush in their prime. Even if the sales did not reflect it, this was Rush in their prime. And if the sales did reflect it,
even better,
yeah.
You know, one line that was awesome in this song, I mean, all the lines were good, but one line that really stood out for me from the rest was, the king has to kneel and his kingdom has to rise. That's a great phrase. The king must kneel and his kingdom must rise.
Yeah, beautifully put together. There were a couple of lines in that.
Many lines.
Which stood out.
Of the royal family, how the by birth only you become somebody great and things like that in the first few lines. And then goes on to the Bastille Day marching.
There was an article just a couple of days ago on the internet, on a leading publication, I mean internet website for news. And it mentioned about the royalty. All the royalties, I don't know if it's royalties, all the royalty around the world, they all live such a lavish lifestyle, a luxurious lifestyle. We marvel at it. We see their weddings. We marvel at it. We applaud. We wish we could be close by while they went down the streets. But the article highlighted some interesting facts. It talked about different royalty, whether it was in Thailand, whether it was in England, whether it was in Sweden or some other places that there's royalty. And it said that all the money that they live on is thanks to the people of that country. And these people are just blowing it. They are living such a lavish lifestyle. They're just doing what they want with the money. They don't care about the poor of their country. They don't really care about the poor of the land. Today you have the parliament system there. You know, so we kind of... oversee how much these people spend, the royalty.
That's what I was going to say.
But the fact is that it doesn't take away from the fact that they are pretty shameless in the way they spend their money.
On your money.
And this is what happens when you do that. At the end of the day, no one lets you get
after centuries. After centuries, people have gotten used to of the royalty being living like a royalty, always having the silver spoon or always having everything that they wanted, and the poor never having the things that they needed. But the fact remains the same, just because we have parliamentary system and we are democratic now and XYZ because of the modernization, they still live on the money that somebody else's was, that they grabbed at one point of time, and they continue to do that. And once you have wealth, you keep generating wealth. Wealth attracts wealth.
Okay, anything about the music you would like to share about this song? Then we just wrap it up by summarizing the four songs and you will talk mostly.
I love the music, and I know the people who watch us, they know by my expressions, by the reactions that we give, that I really like the music. I love when the guitar and the drums are going together and the drums would come. I mean, that was a bit childish for me to enjoy that way, but it was made that way. So towards the end, it did really sound glorious. As I mentioned it already,